Anyway, last Friday night, myself and Kevin Boyd went to see the Watsons, and Kev's been busy doing his review, and he's going to give you it straight after this. This is the Watsons.
Go home, all you bold and your rambling boys, and the warning take by me. For I'd have you quit night walking and shun that company. For it's
son, oh son, what have you done? You're bound for Botany Bay.
I was born and bred in Whitby town and raised most honestly. Till I became a roving blade which proved me destiny. For it's
son, oh son, what have you done? You're bound for Botany Bay.
Well, I broke into some lady's house about the hour of three, and two peelers stood behind the door, and they soon had an hold on me. For it's
son, oh son, what have you done? You're bound for Botany Bay.
It was at
the Watsons, and both in terms of influence over other artists and in repertoire, the Watsons have been one of the leading lights in the folk scene for the past 20 years. Now a five-piece, Mike's daughter, Rachel, have joined them recently, joined also by Lal and Norma Watson, Martin Carthy, and of course Mike himself. Now look, Watsons sound as fresh as ever. They kicked off the night with one of the most recent songs, Shepherds Are the Cleverest Lads, from the Greenfields album, and proceeded to run through what could be considered as their greatest hits. The first half included many older songs, though, which they admitted they hadn't sung for a while, and there were a few hiccups, but I'm sure most people will forgive them for that. Max didn't seem too comfortable a lot of the time, and he confided with me afterwards that he didn't start to enjoy the gig until the last two songs, but I'm sure the audience wouldn't agree. Nevertheless, it didn't spoil the evening, and there were a few amusing moments when he made a few hiccups as well, which is quite rare at a Watson's gig, by the way. A short first half was rounded off, leaving us all craving for more, and wondering what was in store in the second half. Before the Watson's second appearance, though, the floor singers took the stage, and one of them was none other than Jim Boys of the group Swan Arcade, playing a guitar, no doubt. And Jim presented a pleasant selection of songs. There was nothing astonishing about it, but for the average club goer, I'm sure we all enjoyed it. The main attraction then took the stage yet again, and in no time they were wooing the audience with their amazing harmonies and perfect synchronicity. It wasn't long before four of the members left the stage and Martin Carthy got up to do his solo spot. Here's an example of what he's capable of.
He called for a candle to light his way to bed, and likewise a handkerchief to tie around his head. But to tie around his head like the sailors often do, and he says, me pretty fair, mate, will you go too? And Maggie was a young girl, and she thought it was no harm. She laid her down beside him to keep his bosom warm. In the middle of the fight, when the sailor he grew bold, he throwed into a raper and £500 in gold. And it was early the next morning when Maggie's mother rose, saying, daughter, dearest daughter, you have thrown yourself away. You have thrown yourself away and you've birthed a baby. And you'll pass for a young girl in a foreign country. Oh, mother, dearest mother, oh, I've done nothing wrong. For I've gold in me pocket and silver in me purse. And when me baby's born, we will pay the nurse a fee. and a bass for a young girl in a foreign country. And if it be a girl child, she'll stay at home with me. And if it be a boy, he will blow the dark blue sea. He'll blow the dark blue sea like his daddy done before. And he'll skip about the deck like a young sailor boy. And it is God bless the ocean that my love sails upon. And likewise the bonny ship that carries him along. I'll write me love a letter and I'll seal it with a ring. And I never will be happy till me love returns again.
An excellent example there of the singing of Martin Carthy. That was called He Called for a Candle. After Martin's solo spot, the two sisters, Lal and Norma, stepped up to perform a duet, which was not bad, but I think the fumbling with the microphones at the start just spoiled it a little bit. Anyway, back to all five members, the second half rolled on in memorable fashion. The high point of the whole evening came with a fairly new song, actually. It's only 2 or 3 years old, called The Prickle Holly Bush, which never fails to amaze me, despite its oft-repeated verses and choruses. After another slip-up from Mike and the song I Went to Market, apparently you can't tell the difference between birds and pigs, I don't know, they finished off the night in a blaze of glory. At one point, I listened to each of the individual voices to try and sort of evaluate them and to find out what sort of contribution each individual member was making. I found out that Norma had quite a strong voice. She's probably the leader. Rachel, the newest member, is not so strong and not so experienced, so you can't really blame her for that. Mike was the unmistakable sound of the Watersons. Lala, the strong and powerful voice. And Martin, although he's got a very distinctive voice, he was mainly drowned out by the rest of the band. That was a bit of a disappointment. Anyway, back to the high point of the night. From the LP The Green Fields, this is called The Prickle Holly Bush.
I'll slash your old Christ George.
Come slack it for a while, for I think I see my father coming over yonder stile.
Did you bring gold?
Did you bring silver to set me free? For to keep my body from the cold jail wall and me neck from the high gallows tree.
I've no gold,
I've no silver to set you free. For I am crippled to see you hang, oh, hang upon the high gallows tree. Oh, the prickle holly bush, it pricks, oh, it pricks my heart for sore. And if ever I get out of the prickle holly bush, I'll never get in there anymore.
I'll slack your oars, cries George.
Come slack it for a while, for I think I see my mother coming over yonder stile.
Did you bring gold?
Did you bring silver to set me free? Or to keep my body from the cold jail wall and me neck from the high gallows tree?
I've no gold,
I've no silver to set you free. But I am crippled to see you hang, oh, hang upon the high gallows tree. Oh, the prickle holly bush, it pricks, oh, it pricks my heart for sore. And if ever I get out of the prickle holly bush, I'll never get in there anymore.
I'll slack your oars, cries George.
I'll slack it for a while, for I think I see my sister coming over yonder stile.
Did you bring gold?
Did you bring silver to set me free? For to keep my body from the cold jail wall and me neck from the high gallows tree.
I've no gold,
I've no silver to set you free. jolly boots, I'll never get in there anymore.
I'll slank your oars, cries George.
Come slank it for a while, for I think I see my sweetheart coming over yonder stile.
Did you bring gold?
Did you bring silver to set me free? For to keep my body from the cold jail wall and me neck from the high gallows tree.
I brought gold.
I brought silver to set you free. For I'm not cruel for to see you hang, I'll hang upon the high gallows tree. Oh, the prickle of the bush, it tricks, oh, it tricks my heart for sore. And now that I'm out of the prickle of the bush, I'll never get in there anymore.
The Prickle Holly Bush there, from the Watersons. And the end of a great night, and I'm sure Alan will agree with me. Now then, earlier on I mentioned a group called Blue Murder. I said there were a new group, but there were an old group as well. And I'll explain a bit now. The Watersons and another vocal harmony group, Swan Arcade, have got together to form an 8-piece vocal harmony group. How does that sound, eh?
8-part harmony.
Yeah, and they're appearing at the WAF Montgomery Hall on November the 1st, so get along there if you can.
Sounds like a good one.
Yeah. Right, and also, just a quickie before we go, if you get hold of this week's Folk Roots magazine, and Alan's terribly jealous because I got hold of mine a week before he has, you'll find Martin Carthy, God, as he's known in our house, on the front cover. And also, we've got a group called Filar Folkette, or something.
I
think
they're from
the Swedish.
Sweden.
Yeah.
Or, yeah.
Roger Wilson, a newcomer, a friend of Pete Morton's. Another group I can't pronounce called Quilla Payun.
There you go. Pronounced it.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
The Balam Alligators, Taj Mahal. Oh, Taj Mahal, eh?
Great.
He's still around. Martin Carthy, I've just mentioned, and lots of other good stuff. Folk Roots charts and letters. 2000 and more, a folk idiocy. Folk Roots own cartoon strip as well, isn't there? So buy it if you can. It's only £1.40. It's great value.
Great.
What do you think?
Fantastic.
And you were there with me on Friday night, and I know you enjoyed it.
Great, yeah. Well, yeah, great. It's the first time I've seen Watersons, and I really enjoyed it.
Mm.
Good. A
rare appearance. Apparently, I was reading this Folk Roots interview with Martin Carthy. They haven't been on the road for 19 years, just doing the occasional show. You know, but they haven't done a proper tour, anything, for 19 years.
Oh, that's interesting. Yes, well, we saw them.
Yeah.
Are they on anywhere local in the future?
I don't know, but I know, like I say, Blue Murder are on.
Oh, yeah,
in
of course.
But I don't know about the Watersons on their own.
Well, if you want to see the Watersons, get along to the Montgomery Hall. That's all
I can say. No doubt they'll be doing some Watersons songs amongst the other stuff.